All right, so what vitamins and supplements do I take as an eye doctor to help maximize my eye health, prevent eye disease, and improve my eyesight? So in today's video, I'm going to be breaking down my supplement routine and what I take to help my eyes, my brain, my stress levels, even my physical fitness. That's what we're talking about. Let's take a look. Now, to start off, before we dive in, I think it is super important to mention that I personally have only been diagnosed with myopia, astigmatism, dry eye disease, and meibomian gland dysfunction. I have never been diagnosed with conditions like diabetes, glaucoma, or age-related macular degeneration. But some people out there who suffer with those diseases may have been prescribed or recommended supplements specifically to help those individual conditions. And so I think it's super important to keep in mind to always talk to your local eye doctor about what is best for you and your eye health. All right, so starting off, I take supplements of lutein and zeaxanthin. These are xanthophyll carotenoids that are found often in green leafy vegetables like spinach and kale, but also found in egg yolk to some extent. Xanthophyll carotenoids, when they travel through your bloodstream, they deposit in the eye at a concentration 1,000 times greater than what is found just typically floating in the bloodstream. When they deposit in the eye, they work as antioxidants and anti-inflammatories, but they also act as nature's natural blue light blocker. They actually filter out high-energy blue light that passes through the eye and hits the retina. Research has shown that people who take supplements of xanthophyll carotenoids, such as lutein and zeaxanthin, can boost the macular pigment in the retina, and that is associated with a reduced risk of aging eye diseases, such as macular degeneration. There's also publications showing that taking these supplements can improve visual performance, mainly through improved contrast sensitivity, which helps you detect smaller differences in different things, elements in your eyesight, especially in low light situations. Also, it reduces glare, which may be important if you're staring at a computer screen all day or if you drive, again, in low light situations. Also, it helps improve photo stress recovery and visual processing speed, which means you may be able to process visual information a lot faster within your brain. There's also research showing that supplementation of these carotenoids can improve cognition and memory in adults, and a newer publication shows similar results when children are taking this type of supplement. There's also publications showing that lutein and zeaxanthin can help with stress levels, sleep, and with dry eyes. And then a very new publication just found that taking these types of supplements can reduce the inflammatory cytokines, which are linked to atherosclerosis development, which is the reason why we develop heart attack and stroke. For lutein, I take somewhere between 10 and 20 milligrams a day, and for zeaxanthin, between 2 and 4 milligrams a day. And as far as the research goes for these two supplements, I consider it to be pretty moderate to strong evidence. Next up is that of curcumin or curcuminoids, which is a derivative of turmeric. This has been used in many clinical studies as of late because of its antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, being studied for metabolic disease, diabetes, cancer, Alzheimer's, skin care, and even as a pain therapeutic. In the eye care space, it's been used in research for retinal disease, mainly because of its, again, antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, but also in dry eye research. The research on retinal disease is mainly done in animals, such as in mice, so it's definitely lacking in human studies in that specific area, but there are human studies looking at it as a benefit for dry eye disease, and so that's primarily why I choose to take it. Now, historically, curcuminoids are known to have a poor bioavailability, meaning even though you ingest it, your body doesn't necessarily absorb it all that well. So it's often paired with something called piperine, which is an alkaloid of black pepper. And so when taken together, your intestinal wall can better absorb these curcuminoids and then also process it in the liver better. So frequently, or in the past, I used to take about 1,000 milligrams of curcumin a day mixed with about 10-15 milligrams of piperine. However, New research has found a better way to process and make nanocurcumin or microcellular curcumin. And these curcuminoids have even greater bioavailability. So now I take about 200 milligrams of this nanocurcumin every single day. And usually I take this in a kind of a multivitamin specifically made for the eyes, which I will talk more about a little bit later in the video. But as far as the research goes, especially for curcumin being beneficial for dry eye, again, I consider it pretty moderate evidence. With, of course, I'd like to see more extensive research, particularly in retinal health and with human subjects. All right, next up is that of omega-3 fatty acids. Now, we've talked extensively about omega-3s and the benefits for the eyes here on this channel, but historically, omega-3s have been known to be beneficial for cardiac reasons, mainly for reducing triglyceride levels, for helping lower blood pressure slightly, as well as helping with heart rate and then just lowering inflammation in general. Now, that's not without controversy, but at least in the eye care space, they have found that the omega-3s have a significant impact on both eye health and brain health, specifically in the form of DHA omega-3. In fact, about 50 to 60% of the fatty acid content found within the phospholipid membranes of rod photoreceptors in the retina are made up of DHA. With pretty extensive research showing that people who consume more oily fish have a reduced risk of not only developing, but also reduced risk of progression in retinal diseases such as diabetic retinopathy and macular degeneration, both of which are pretty common and potentially blinding retinal conditions. There's also a lot of research on the use of omega-3s for helping dry eye disease. It's not without controversy. Again, we've done several videos on that, and the research is pretty extensive and kind of goes all over the place. But myself, I have personally experienced improvement in my dry eye scores and dry eye symptoms when taking omega-3s, so that's one of the reasons why I choose to continue taking it. Now, I personally try really hard to eat a healthy diet first, which includes eating oily fish at least twice a week, but I take supplements of somewhere between 1,000 milligrams and 2,400 milligrams of omega-3s every single day. Specifically, I've had great success using the PRN brand of omega-3 that's more designed and formulated for dry eyes. It has about 1680 milligrams of EPA and about 560 milligrams of DHA in those supplements. I do also want to mention that there is some really interesting research on phospholipid and lipophospholipid DHA as potentially being more bioavailable for neural tissue, including the brain and retina. There is some small research in animal studies potentially showing benefits for retinal diseases, but again, very early research, and we need more studies on that. Now, next up is that of vitamin D. Now, most people know of vitamin D's role in bone growth and development, but it's also been found to play a role in inflammation, as well as modulation of cell growth, neuromuscular and immune function, as well as glucose metabolism. The challenge is that most people, we get our vitamin D from getting out in the sunlight, but like many people, I spend most of my day indoors in front of a computer screen, and when I do go outside, I'm often wearing many layers of clothing, I'm wearing sunglasses and sunscreen to protect my face and my skin from UV light damage. Specifically with the eyes, research has shown that vitamin D plays a role in both dry eye and corneal wound healing. I find the evidence kind of low to moderate, and I would like to see more research on that, but for the other benefits of vitamin D, and knowing that I just don't get much sunlight, that is one of the reasons why I choose to take a supplement. Now, because many foods are fortified with vitamin D, and there is a real risk of vitamin D toxicity, I choose to only take about 1,000 to 2,000 international units of vitamin D3 a day. And in fact, I get most of that from taking other supplements, because it's often included in other forms of supplementation, such as the PRN omega-3 that I take has vitamin D3 in it, and another supplement I take for my eyes also has vitamin D in it, which I'll again we'll be talking about in just a little bit. Next is astaxanthin. Astaxanthin is a carotenoid that has about 40 times the antioxidant capacity of other beta carotene-like carotenoids. And I recently did a video going more in depth on the research about the eyes and astaxanthin, but it's been found to improve blood flow to certain components of the eye, helping with eye strain, dry eyes, and potentially slowing down cataract development. I think the research in the eyes is still pretty weak evidence, and I think we need more studies on that. But there is pretty modest evidence on astaxanthin on skin health, and it has been shown to help improve production and the quality of sebum expression, which may play a role in the development and helping meibomian glands produce better. It also has been shown in research to help with matrix metalloproteinase production, as well as inflammation in the skin. Again, all things that may help with meibomian gland and dry eye. I personally take about 12 milligrams of astaxanthin every other day or so. I don't take it every day because I'm also getting astaxanthin in my diet just through eating oily fish. Now, in the past, I used to take individual pills or tablets for each one of these supplements. But recently, Blink NutriTears came out, which is a supplement from Bausch & Lomb based on a couple of studies for dry eye. And this contains a lot of these supplements that I've talked about, including lutein, zeaxanthin, vitamin D, and the curcuminoids. And so I've consolidated down to just taking one of these supplements a day alongside my omega-3s and occasionally my astaxanthin. Because, you know, who wants to take a buffet of supplements all day? And then on a side note, I also take about 5 milligrams of creatine every day. And there is research into creatine being benefit for depression and maybe brain health, but I primarily take it for the most well-known reason of athletic performance and muscle development. I also, on occasion, will take an electrolyte mix of the dry eye drink or the dry eye drink PM, which the PM version has some melatonin in it, which I do like a lot when I go on big traveling trips where I go give lectures in early mornings and I'm usually up late at night socializing. And so those sort of drinks can help me sleep a little bit better. Now, just because I choose to take a supplement does not mean that you should. Many of these supplements can interact with medications or cause problems when taken in excess. So I think it's always important to consult with your local family doctor as well as with your eye doctor if you are ever considering to take a supplement. Also, I always encourage people to focus on the fundamentals, things like diet, exercise, and sleep. In fact, sleep is a really interesting subject in the field of eye care right now. So if you want to see more information about that, including tips on what I've done to help improve my own sleep habits, then check out my future video that I'll be putting up over here to the side. Or if you're interested in learning more about diets and how they affect the eye, whether it be the ketogenic diet or intermittent fasting, then check out my next series coming up over here. Otherwise, Dr. Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. Thank you so much for joining me. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in those next videos.